Hello! Today we are talking about, we're going old school, we're going to past master and past matron swinger jewels. And we have a case for them we'll also go over. So there are two types that we have. We have gold filled and then gold plated, and I'll give you a closer look at that. And so let's look at those first. These are the gold filled swinger jewels. These are just four examples of what we have, actually five examples of what we have, and I'll get closer so I know they're kind of blurry now, overexposed. But gold filled essentially is about, they're all made of brass, and on the gold filled there's probably 50 times more gold that is then overlaid on top of the brass than on the gold plated. So gold plate has a very, very thin layer of gold that's on it, and gold filled has a thicker layer of gold that's on it. It's really your personal preference and your wallet. You'll see these gold filled ones. So here's the, we'll get closer to this. This is a OES, past matron jewel. And then there's a past high priest. And then there's a past matron also with the gavel and a G for the past master. Again, you can kind of see the detail of the in the gold filled, what those look like. You also can get in engraving, so you can, I'll get close enough here, hopefully the exposure on that, you can see that's what the engraving looks like. So you can get your lodge name and number and your year on that. Some, as you'll see, have extra bars that you can add to it. This is another style of past master jewel, and it's in a case, which we'll go over in a minute. And here are the gold plated ones. Here are some past master ones, so you see the extra bars. So if you have those engraved, you can see you could put your name here and then your lodge information here, your name here. Again, it's limited by the number of units. So if you belong to Chickahominy Lodge and you have a very long name, that will be limiting on what else you can put on your bar. Here is one with a G. Again, these are gold plated and you can go see those. These run about $62. This is for a past matron, and then two more past master. Again, some have the square compass and quadrant, or compasses and quadrant, and then some just have the compasses and quadrant, like that one. And these are about 3 inches tall. That's what they are. And then if we got this one for Shaq in case he ever became a past master, we figured that would be tall enough for him. Or if you just want to really let everybody know you've been a past master, you can wear this bad boy in. And that one's about 7 inches tall. You can see that ruler. And then we also have a case that they come in. So this case basically allows you to put this and slot it into your jacket. So you don't have to pin it onto your suit. You can just slide it into your jacket. And then if I can do this with one hand, it comes in its own case so you can protect it. You'll be able to do this with two hands, so it'll be easier. But this is how the case closes, and that's how it works. And then you can put that in your apron case. So there you go. Swinger jewels, past master and past matron swinger jewels. Check them out at Macoy.com. Thanks.